Okay, so in today's video, I'm going to show how to find something that is lost in the ocean. Now, several weeks ago, I got a call from our friends at Mobile Marine. They had a situation where they had an ocean-going tug lose a propeller in the ocean, and they wanted to find it. So we decided we want to help, but how do you find something that's lost in the ocean? This is a pretty difficult task because us as divers, it's not like you can just jump in a general area and swim all around and find something. You have to be right on it. In this case, we had some data on our side. The tugboat and the captain had a recorded GPS track. So we could look at that track information and we can see that tugboat was on like an autopilot heading pretty much due south. Then it looks like there's a few jogs in the track. And we theorized that one of these jogs is when the captain realized there was an issue, he put the boat in neutral and that would have caused some movement. And then we also see a smaller jog in the track just north of that. And we think that might be where the actual prop fell off. So our plan was to go offshore and scan the area to try to find it.
All right, today we're going offshore to try and find a lost prop in a big ocean.
Now to search for the prop, we went offshore and we tried to do some sonar survey. Just using a traditional offshore fishing boat with traditional sonar sounding, a traditional depth finder. We had a side scan capability on this boat as well. It shoots out the signal to the side of the boat. So in theory, you might be able to see anything that's on the ground out a good ways from each side of the boat, but it's not as detailed as it could be.
It's like, you know, it's like hard to say, would it show up like this or something more contrasting?
I think it'd be more contrast than that.
And we went back and forth many times and we had no luck. We didn't see anything that we could even remotely try to identify as a prop.
Trying to find a needle in a haystack.
Thankfully, our very good friends with the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office came out with some very specialized equipment. And when they came out, they went ahead and they put their side scan sonar into the water. This is a sonar system. The main unit looks like a torpedo. It's something that has to be dragged behind the boat. They can see both port side and starboard side of the vessel out a couple hundred feet or so. And any obstructions that are on the seafloor will show up in this sonar. And better yet, when we find an obstruction, that obstruction can be selected and then we can be given the GPS coordinates to that.
Solid.
So we searched and searched and searched, and finally we found an anomaly that looked like it was probably the most likely potential item to be a prop, although it wasn't very convincing. So we came back, we marked the spot, and we sent a police diver down. However, we knew we were gonna have very bad visibility, likely no visibility. So the officer took down a handheld underwater sonar system. And so when she got to the seafloor, she had no visibility, but she knew she was likely close. But if you're not right on it, no visibility, it's no good. You gotta be able to find it still. And if it's 5 feet away, it might as well be 5 miles away if you don't swim in the right direction. So this underwater sonar would allow to see an anomaly underwater. She could see that with the sonar, swam towards it, came up to the surface, and told us that she had located the prop. So now we have found the prop, and that's fantastic. We know exactly where it's at from a GPS standpoint. The problem is we were not able to go back out to try to salvage the prop until several weeks later after several storms and some rough ocean conditions. And after all these big seas events, I was worried it could likely be buried. And so this was a big gamble day because now we had the barge, the tug, and the crane on site. And if we could not find the propeller again, then it would be a big waste of time.
It's like 5:30 and it's a lot colder than we expected it to be. It is like 30 something degrees outside. There's ice on the top of the car.
That's ice.
Today's the day we try to go get the prop out of the ocean and hope the water is warmer than it's forecasted to be.
Game time. Cross our fingers we can find it.
We made our way out. A tug and barge made their way out. They had probably like a day and a half commute to get there. And at this point, we know where the prop is, but we have to find it again. So that means we have to send divers back down. They have to relocate the prop. And that sounds simple enough because we have the exact coordinates. But if we have no vis conditions, that's very difficult. And this time we did not have the underwater sonar equipment that JSO had, before. So what we did in this scenario is basically we took a weighted jug. That weighted jug was thrown on our GPS coordinates from where we located the prop before. In theory, the prop should be somewhere within feet of where we drop our marker jug.
Buoy has been dropped on the site. Barge will get positioned, divers go down, tie off the prop. Sounds easy enough.
How cold is the water, Ed?
It's 54 degrees. Let's put it this way. It's not conducive for this body to be in that water.
In this case, we had to send some hard hat divers down. They had to search. It actually took quite a while.
We got a little nervous here because the first diver was down 45 minutes, did not find the prop. Prior to the second diver going down, we went ahead and re-looked at the jug again, and we thought it was maybe 40 feet off or so. So we went ahead and we replaced the jug in what we thought was a more accurate position. At this point, diver two gets in.
Just got report they have found the prop. They are now rigging the prop up to the crane. Next up will be the pull the prop from the ocean floor.
It is.
So there it is, 8 feet in diameter, several thousand pounds. It's a big, beefy prop.
Pretty amazing that this worked out. Everyone's really thrilled and just really cool that with the right teams, the right effort, and the right technology, that something as small as a boat prop can be found in a very big ocean, removed from the ocean, brought back, and put into service.